Now, the front part is everything. So you just say focus, and I think you can focus. I think you can focus. Front part is all EMF, right? So cubic, quadratic, linear, y equals mx plus c, the straight line, the curve itself with x to the power of a whole number. So all these are EMAX. Then what is the AMAX part? AMAX part is when the power is a fraction. So in the notes itself, we went on to cover. So remember this part where we say, if it's whole number, even number, it's all u, right? Whether it's x squared, x4, it's all u. Oi, here already. Listen first. If it's odd number, x cubed, x5, x7, it's all the snake or the s or the whatever shape we call it. So these are whole numbers. So what about fraction? So then we go on to fraction, we say, hey, actually, yeah, very easy. I don't care what the fraction is, because where as far as x more than 0 is concerned, it's always starting from 0 till up, then like that, till up, then like that. So whatever fraction is, I don't need to bother, it's just always this shape. So this is for between 0 to 1. Okay? After that, we talk about negative. So negative, what happened? It's like that. So can we summarize these three graphs onto your revision note paper? Okay, so let's start. So let's take a look at your revision note paper. So let's start with revision. Can you write down, can you also write down revision as well? This is your logarithm graph. So if, now, so number one, so if we look at y equals to x power 2 or 4 or 6, well, let's write that very messy, yeah. I'm trying. Now, this one, we are talking about a U shape. This U can be broader or narrower, I don't care, it's just a U shape. Now, next one, if I talk about odd, say y equals to x cubed, y equals to x5, y equals to x7, then I'm talking about a S shape, just like that, okay? So this is number one. Number two, we are concerned about x to the power of a fraction where the fraction is between 0 to 1. So we say x is equals to x to the power of n where n is between 0 to 1. That means a fraction. I don't care whether is it even denominator number or odd denominator number. I know the graph always like that. Why? Because based on the notes actually show us a difference. For fraction, even power, denominator, is only like that. There isn't anything here. So that means half, one-fourth, or one-eighth, or one over six, or one over whatever. One over an even number is a fraction, it's always only like that. But odd number got two. One is like that, one is like that. So there's two. How? Why? Why then you have to go back to the graph paper? I give you a graph paper. You go and calculate, plot all the points, you look like that. You understand? I'm not punishing you. I tell you, why is it like that? Very simple. This graph itself is actually y. This is actually y squared equals to x. Jiaxuan, do you agree? So if I give you a table, I say xy, can you plot minus 3 minus minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Use 10 value. Find out the value of y. Take out a graph paper. Go and draw. It will look like that. Just like that. There's no y. So you put minus 4 inside the x. You square root the minus 4. You get no value. So there's no value here. Can follow? But cube root, if you cube root a negative number, there's a number there. That's why here there's a number. But the curve will look like that. So, but to summarize everything, as long as O level is concerned, they only ask x more than 0. They don't want x less than 0. So you compare the two, actually they look the same. So this is to summarize for fractional power. It looks like that. Now, what about the third one? The third one is still on n, but n is between negative 1 to 0. That means it's a fraction, but a negative fraction that is less than 1. So based on the graph, it looks like that. Right? That was what we saw. So far, okay? Okay, yeah. Now, so if I look at the first one, so now if I look at the question say x, this is a what? Fractional power, right? And the power is less than 1. So what do you think the answer look like? Like that, like that, like that. Full stop. Just like that. Of course, you label by writing yx. Then this is y equals to 3x power half. This is the answer. Yeah. Huh? There's a 3. The 3 doesn't matter. The 3 doesn't matter because the 3 only affect the gradient of the curve. But you notice, Isabel, there's a x lesser or equal to 36. So what this means is they want you to plot when x is 36, what is the point? So can you sub in and tell me the answer? 36 comma what? Put into a calculator. Jun Yang, are you talking about this question? Are you sure? 6. Okay, now 18, because there's a times 3, right? Now, I'm going to show you that I'm not bluffing you by showing you the decimals part. So this whole worksheet can be done with decimals. So let me show you how to call out decimals. So y equals to x to the power of 0.5. Do you see? Shh. Focus. Do you see I'm not bluffing you? It's really like that. But Jiaxuan asks, hey, even if there's a 3 there, you mean it still look like that? Okay, let me show you by creating another graph. Okay, do you see it is still the same shape except it is like steeper, but in sketching they don't care about anything. As long as you give the shape, they give you the mark. So therefore, this question, the answer is just like that. Full stop. Can follow? Easy? But you must label because they purposely say x is less than or equal to 36. So you just like label the point for them. It's not difficult because you just sub in. Yes, for part 2 is simultaneous. So to find the coordinate, you always use substitution. Do you know this is in chapter 9 summary page? Do you want me to show you? I show you are, then you will be surprised. Can you all try to act surprised? Do you remember this summary page? It says, to find a point. To find a point, the first method is always solving simultaneous equation. Meaning to say, if I want to solve one coordinate, very simple, I just solve simultaneous, I can find the coordinate. I don't care whether is it two straight line or is it a curve and a straight line. Okay, so this is very useful. You can see this appearing everywhere. Chapter 9, chapter 6, I don't care, chapter 2, it will come out. Okay, so a very standard question. So I look at this. I must remind myself, don't go too fast, but can I skip question 2?